All right.
You're on TV there.
We'll call the January 2017 meeting of the Tree Advisory Commission to order. We have the agenda before us. Has everyone had a chance to read the minutes? Any corrections or additions? Whoops. Yeah, I can't remember. What is our protocol? Do we read them or do we just review them?
I think we have to approve the minutes.
Okay.
And I would make that motion.
We have a motion to approve the minutes of the last meeting dated November 10th, 2016. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. We have a motion passed to accept the minutes of the 2016, the November 10th, 2016 committee meeting. Okay, second. We have the 2017 commission members in terms election of 2017 officers. Where do we proceed from there? Has that been done or is it in process?
No, that's actually something we would like to conduct now. Normally, okay. It's done late the year before the last meeting of 2016 in November. We didn't get that taken care of. So please lead the charge as far as electing a chair and a vice chair.
Okay. Well, let's go with the vice chair first. Do we have any nominations for vice chair for 2017?
I'll nominate Scott.
Okay. Any other nominations? Do we have a motion nomination cease?
Make a motion.
All right, we make a motion, okay. All in favor of Scott as vice chair in 2017? So moved.
Aye.
Okay. All right. Nominations for chair. Do we have any nominations for chair of the committee this year?
I'll make a motion to nominate Wayne.
Okay. Okay, any other nominations? I'll make a motion. Nomination cease. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
All right. Our 2017 officers are Wayne Schopper as chair, Scott Sparlin as vice chair. Okay, any amendments or can we approve the agenda for today? Any additions or corrections or changes that anyone can see?
I would make a motion that we approve the agenda.
Do I have a second?
Second it.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Very aye. Good, okay. Same sign, okay. We talked about approving the November 10th, 2016 minutes, so that is completed already. Okay, let's start with old business under 5A, City Tree Reimbursement Program 2016 budget updates in 2017. Mr. Kaler, he is not here, so we'll move on. PUC, Tree Reimbursement Programs 2016 budgets updates 2017, Mr. Swanson.
All right. Well, I guess our accounts aren't closed out at the time of this latest update, and I believe we may have one or two rebates remaining. The total spent as of previous month was $2,363 for tree reimbursements, and I think once, probably in February, once we close out the accounts, I'll tally up the trees and see the types of trees that were planted. And then on the bottom, you can see there's a couple rebates there. A few of those, I believe they said they were not able to plant during the 2016 year. So I expect one or two of those will be put back towards 2016. For the upcoming 2017 year, we do have $3,000 that's been awarded for the shade tree program, and I don't foresee any changes to the rebate amounts for the program. So it'd be very similar to the 2016 year.
Okay.
Does anything carry over if it wasn't spent in your budget?
I guess for this, it would be possible to request a carryover in funds. I do not typically request a carryover unless we were to have potential for rebates that I know will be completed in 2017 that weren't completed in 2016. My current plans are not to do a budget carryover, but I guess the Tree Commission requested that maybe something we could look at. And I guess the procedure for that would be I would request the Public Utilities Commission for a budget carryover from the 2016 year to the 2017 year.
Any further questions or discussion?
You see that as a further, you see that as an issue at all?
The total.
Needing the carryover?
Oh, I would say not at this point. Usually there's a little bit of flexibility. I guess I say we have the $3,000 in funding. I believe we might be a bit below that for total spend for the 2016 year. I would say most likely in the 2017 year, as long as our total conservation improvement funds are below the maximum spending level, we could potentially exceed that for the 2017 year. So that's some of my reasoning for, I guess at this point, not moving forward with a budget carryover on my own.
All right, moving on. Buckthorn Removal Volunteer Program update. Ellen Van Cura, she's not here, so we'll keep moving on to the through the agenda. Minnesota Green Corps Tree Inventory, Tree Planning, Tree City USA U of M Cost Benefit Study, Even Months Tree Commission Meeting or Work Session. MRSA, am I saying that correctly, in Schnellberg? Okay, yes.
Hey, good evening. So for my updates, I'll start off with the tree inventory. As of right now, 7 of 30 some parks have been inventoried. I'm saying about 30 parks because there are a number of undeveloped parks out there that I don't foresee from the start tackling those. We're just going to focus on the boulevards and also parks with more dispersed space trees. In addition to the tree inventory with volunteers, I'm also going to be I'm in the process of developing a survey questionnaire of sort to learn about private residences and commercial property, about the trees that they have on their property. So species, a size, and then also number of trees. And so I'm not sure if that's going to be a mail survey as of yet or an online questionnaire, but that would be, I'm working on that, and that would be coming out around the same time as this inventory gets going, like April, May.
Shane, I have a question about that.
Yes.
How accurate do you think that will be given people's ability to tell species?
Sure. I guess that's on my part, like how well I can describe things. I do have a draft working right now, mm-hmm. And I'm including a lot of pictures of leaves okay. and some seeds on there. And so maybe even a little picture of where on the tree I'm looking for people to kind of get a size estimate, and we're just keeping it at the genus, maple, oak, cottonwood, some specifics like Kentucky coffee tree, but, sure. Just trying to keep it simple and easy to understand and report.
Would you be available if someone does have a question about identification?
Yes, okay. Yep. I will have that included in there. If somebody's just really not sure, I'll have my my phone number and my email.
Okay.
Excellent. Attached to this.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
Shane, with the volunteers that you have advertised for and the U of M, are they going to be doing some training? Is the U of M going to do some training with the volunteers to help them identify?
Yes. Yep. They will be leading the volunteer training for the main inventory. They will be providing a lot of materials, little pamphlets, identification guides, kind of survey guide, and it'll be going over that, and it could be taking place a few hours over 2 days or just 1 day for, I think it's maybe 4 to 6 hours, from my understanding.
Shane, one more question. Backing up a little bit about the parks you mentioned, some of the parks are not going to be inventoried.
Yes.
And such. Would it be helpful or useful or possible to maybe utilize some drone pictures for those to get a good general idea of a diversification of species there? And because I know there are good camera people out there that have them and have the ability maybe to help out with that. Maybe that's an idea, something that could augment the overall picture. You know, mm-hmm. being that it is city property and that the parks are a part of it, we would want to get an accurate account as best we can, you mm-hmm. know, especially in the light of disease and stuff.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I haven't gotten too deep into how to go through those undeveloped areas, but I think that's one option, you know, drone pictures, aerial photos. I don't have a good understanding of that, so it would be something like you said, something to augment the volunteer inventory. I think it'd be very useful to get the whole picture of New Ulm.
If mm-hmm. you have trouble finding a drone, get a hold of me and I might be able to put you on to something.
Okay,
like that,
thank you.
So.
I might interject just a little bit here also, commissioners, advisors, and Shane. We've been really talking and looking, focusing on use areas of use parks and boulevard areas and the trail. Some of these parks that might not be in this first round of inventory are some of the urban wilderness areas that we have, such as Adams Park, South Market Park, the Herman Harmon Hillside, where you're just, I mean, it's a cluster forest.
Sure. Minicon.
Yeah, Minicon, exactly. Yeah. Correct. Good. So Shane is just assisting us in getting the initial inventory framework set up and prioritizing what we think we can do this year with Shane's time and the volunteers in kind of year one of our effort. And we anticipate this to be an ongoing process for many years. Mm. Just wanted to interject that.
Excellent. Thank you.
Okay. So also related to the tree inventory, I've been doing a lot of volunteer outreach, as Lisa knows. So there have been emails. I've been emailing schools, churches, civic groups. And also putting out flyers in select locations, grocery stores, city buildings. And then also I was in an article in the journal talking about what I'm doing here. And so, which I'm very happy for. I think that travels quite a bit on the internet. Very cool to see. And so there will be more outreach. I spend maybe November and December doing this first round. The second round, I'm thinking in late winter, kind of updating current volunteers on what's happening. And then when we get closer to spring, having a better idea of when leaf out is going to be on the leaves, because that would be the best time to really identify trees for everybody, I think, all the volunteers, no matter what your skill level is. And I'm happy to say that right now, I have over 20 volunteers so far, including individuals, and also the Lions Club have expressed they have a number of members. And so I'm hoping that continues in the future. During the next topic I want to bring up, the Tree City USA, just a brief update that the application has been completed and it's been submitted and approved by the state forester. Now we're just waiting for the Arbor Day to get back and be looking at Arbor Day year 14. The next thing is the U of M cost benefit study. This wasn't something that was able to be mentioned at the last meeting. Gary Johnson from the University of Minnesota's Department of Forest Resources had contacted Tom and I about inviting them to be part of a cost-benefit study on different types of planting methods. And so he had sent an undergrad research assistant who came here in late November, December, and looking at park and rec trees that were planted in 2016. So she came and put little metal tags on trees, and also looking at the caliper size, taking the measurements. And then we also provided information on how the tree, details on the planting, how they were planted, what kind of tools were used, and also how the trees came to us, whether bare root or containerized, and other details like that. They'll be continuing to monitor these trees over the next 3 years, and then by the end, they will do their assessment, and then they'll be reporting back with insight that they've gained from the study. And so Tom will be the contact for that after I've left. Okay. And then the last thing pertaining to my section here are the work sessions. This was brought up in the last meeting, and a motion was carried for informal work sessions. I intend those work sessions to be just informal meetings for discussions about tree topics, and at first primarily focused on what I'm working on, getting input from all of you and seeing where this growing urban forestry program could go in the future. And so it'll be completely voluntary, and it'll be open to the public as well. So dates that are not accessible are on the section in the agenda packet. And my suggestion for a possible date is the first Thursday of every even month, maybe 4 or 5 o'clock, just to keep it consistent with what the normal meeting for the Tree Advisory Commission.
Any further questions or commentary?
Shane, I just have one question. So with the tree inventory, what do we hope to, you know, obviously gain with that? Like for the boulevards, if they say, oh, 50% of them are maples and 30% are ash, or are we going to say, okay, we're not going to plant any more maples on the boulevards, or where do we want to go with the inventory then once it's done?
Well, that's definitely one thing I'd like to talk about at these work sessions. What's going to be an appropriate plan for the future? I think ash is definitely going to be one tree that you probably don't want to be planting anymore. I know it's not in the Tree Advisory Commission's boulevard and tree plan. There aren't any ash included in that. And so maybe we could have a more formal, maybe making an ordinance to say that we're just not going to be planting ash in light of emerald ash borer in the future. Yeah, that's something that, you know, talking about where this could go and the usefulness of this inventory. Yeah.
Okay.
Excuse me, members and Shane and so on. Again, I've got a little question about the work sessions. I don't know if the commission is interested in kind of making a decision on this now, if you've had enough time to think about it. One option, as Shane has mentioned, is to have a standing work session on those even months. We meet on odd months, so it's always the first Thursday And the formal meetings are here on the odd months, but the even months will also be meeting in kind of a roll up our sleeves and talk about other initiatives and where Shane is at and what we might want to do with the inventory and what some of our goals and objectives are. Do you want to make that decision now? Those meetings would probably not be in these chambers here. We'd set them up at the Civic Center or some other place.
Mr. Chair, commissioners, everyone is busy. And everybody's time is valuable, no doubt. I wonder if it couldn't be possible that we could link in the work sessions prior to or after this commission's meeting. That way, you know, it helps for attendance. You know, if you're just going to pick another hour to come, and like you said, it's not mandatory that you be there. You need to be here for the commission meeting, but mm-hmm. it might kill two birds with one stone. If we could get the council chambers, this would be a great place to do it. If we could get that extra hour. And just meet here prior to us having our commission meeting. And it keeps things fresh, too. You know, so if you did discuss something, mm-hmm. You'd still have it on your mind during the meeting. And, you know, so it's just a thought.
Yeah, that's another great idea. We're, you know, reviewing page 10 of the 10-page packet here on these work sessions. And that's not something that Shane and I thought about. But that may be a brilliant idea for the commission.
Well, I've been called brilliant before. That's why I'll accept that.
Shane, did you say you were thinking of having other people part of that group if they wanted to, so it wouldn't be just some of us in this committee, but other people as well?
Yes, correct. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Maybe some people who are volunteered for the tree survey might be people who would be interested in being part of this group.
Yeah, absolutely.
It may improve attendance for our meetings as well. You know, maybe we would have 8 or 10 people during our meetings that would increase the number of brain power, you know, that we would have for our meetings. And there would be a possibility for someone to come out of the audience and go to the podium and offer an idea. You know, so I think it's a win-win-win.
I think it's most important for the commission for it to fit into the five commissioners' schedule. Do you think coming here at 3 p.m. instead of 4 p.m. on the first Thursday of odd months?
Could we back it up? Could we back it up and have it run from 4 o'clock? You would have your work session and 5 o'clock meeting.
I think that could be done.
That might be an easier situation for folks that work and, you know.
So I really feel strongly that this is for the five commissioners to decide whether you feel like, well, you've got four of them here. Mm-hmm. So if you want to decide now, we can kind of start to try and do the background to get this thing set up.
Mr. Chair, do you feel that would require a motion on our part or just an agreement to quick vote?
Well, what are your wishes? I guess I don't really know if it requires a motion, but what are your wishes, commissioners?
I think I would rather have it after the regular meeting, so because earlier would make it tougher for me for work. So, you know, if a regular meeting's at 4, I think 5 o'clock would be, you know, right after.
Yeah, exactly.
That would work better for me, too.
Yeah, and I have no problem with the 5 o'clock hour either, so.
So we would have
The work session would 4 would be the work session.
The work session
and 5 would be the meeting.
For a work session?
Well, it doesn't matter. I would just say the 4 and 5 o'clock would work better.
Right,
than going to 3.
I prefer the 4 o'clock too. Mm-hmm. So then we have to decide, would it be better to have the meeting first and the work session later or the work session? Probably the work session.
I think
first,
the work session first. That way you would would be fresh and there would be new ideas and possibly something you might want to discuss at the meeting.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Okay. I like it. All right.
Then staff will work with city administration to make sure we can do this, you know, that the room's available and so on and so forth.
Right.
And so staff will look into this, and we'll get back to you in the next couple of weeks.
Further question on the work sessions: would someone be reporting that back as to the tree commission then as part of those work sessions, the findings in general, if commissioners are unable to attend some of the previous work sessions before the next commission meetings, or?
Mr. Chair, and if it's not too much to ask the workload, Shane possibly could provide a summary quickly after that, because he'll be here for the work sessions, and he could provide that that summary of what took place at the work session. If that's agreeable.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'd be agreeable to that. That sounds fine.
Okay. Okay.
And in that way, it would get into the minutes that way as well.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it could be a regular part of it. It should be actually right on the agenda. Always on the agenda.
Mm-hmm.
You know, at least for the year. You know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Very good.
Thank you.
Thank you, Shane. Okay, moving on through the agenda, utility bill stuffer mailing flyers. The next, with a question mark, Mr. Swanson.
All right. I did not secure the kind of final cutoff dates for our two mailers. I'll have to look at that for next meeting. But we are set for April and August. And I think at our previous meeting, we said this meeting might be a time for further discussion as far as themes. I know we would be able to, previous years, we've usually ran the rebates as part of one side. And I would suggest essentially leaving that almost in a permanent fashion. It's a combination of both the public utilities shade tree program and windbreak, as well as the boulevard program offered through city funds. And that would leave usually a two-sided 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. So that would leave the backside open for an additional theme. And I would be open to suggestion for both the April and August stuffers. And I think given that, I'd open it up to commissioner discussion.
Okay. Discussion.
Well, I know we do it twice a year. And so in spring is a good planting time, but so is fall. Mm-hmm. So, you know, to encourage, I mean, even to repeat that again in fall on that one side, that still leaves us two sides each for informational stuff. That way, especially since we aren't using our money all in our reimbursement programs, to encourage that and to refresh people's memory that in the fall time that, because fall is what, is it September, October it comes out?
Well, the second one would be an August mailer. So we'd be a bit before the, you know, the peak planting time. But, you know, I think that does get, it's close enough. It stays in people's mind.
Right.
And I think some of the previous topics that have been discussed are tree diseases that may be affecting various types of trees at those times of the season. It could be planting tips as well.
I think we also talked about the buckthorn and maybe garlic mustard.
Nope.
Putting that in there.
Nope.
Do we ever do things on proper trimming methods, or does some other department do something like that, you know, on how to trim a tree correctly?
Mm-hmm. Pruning is a great topic for these annually or every 2 years.
Yeah. Is there, Mr. Chair, commissioners, is there a, excuse me, is there a certain initiative or project that we, you know, such as the tree inventory, is there something like on that order that we would want to include where we're looking for civic engagement, volunteers? That's also an area besides just the education parts, more of an outreach to the community. And is there something that we'd want community people to help us with or foster or make happen? Any, I would entertain any ideas on that. You know, I mean, I, I don't have a specific, I'm just saying something like that.
I might have something to add to that. For the long term, that is something that I could see happening for the community. I know other communities out there have done a similar thing. I've seen websites that have exactly what you're saying, showing different classes that are happening, different organizations, and promoting what they're doing in the community. There are definitely things out there, volunteer operated, that exactly what you're talking about. So yeah, I could see that becoming part of a larger thing down the road, for sure.
All right, thank you, Shane. Okay. Any further discussion?
Well, Tony, I'm just wondering if there's common themes that you get in your business where people seem to have lots of questions.
You know, a lot of it's tree planting and tree variety, what to pick, what to plant, and stuff like that. But I just want to step back. I'm just looking on the agenda here, and right underneath the utility bill stuff, and we got the big tree contest. Is that something we want to put, that usually go in the April flyer?
It often has.
So do we want to, again, put that in there? If commissioners vote on it and want to do it, that may take one of those sheets up.
Mm-hmm. I would say if we can condense the big tree contest into an appropriate format for one page, I think that would be an appropriate timing. And actually, I can't recall exactly when the big tree contest begins and ends, so maybe let's segue into our next.
It begins in the spring, and I think ends. Is it mid-June or mid-July?
June.
Yeah, I was going to say in the past it was the June, June. So.
Mm-hmm. Reason I know I'm on the, or I have for the past several years, been part of the Big Tree Contest. So, mid-June, and then Floyd Ullman is on the committee with me for a number of years. We would, at that time, make appointments or just go around and do some measuring. So. Yeah, so
very appropriate to put that on the backside of the April mailing.
Get the word out. Yeah, we had a lot of entries last year. So, okay, well, segueing into that, any further comments or commentary on the utility bill stuffer?
I would say maybe. I guess if we're in agreement to move forward with a big tree mailing, I would like to vote on utility, or I guess. Rebate information on one side and big tree stuffer on the back side of the April mailing.
Do we make a motion or do we vote on that? Who wants to make a motion?
I'll make that motion.
Okay, do we have a second to that motion?
A second.
Okay, I'll restate the motion. The motion is to, Bill, why don't you restate it? You've got all the verbiage there.
Okay. I guess a motion would be to include tree rebates and the big tree contest on the April flyer, April utility flyer.
We have a motion, a second on the floor. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Same sign. Okay. Motion is passed. Now, the other commentary on the big tree contest is who is on the subcommittee. We need two people. I will personally volunteer. Anybody else want to?
I can help you out with that.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Thank you. And, you know, I'm remiss. I did not introduce our newest committee member. Would you introduce yourself?
Arlen Boddy.
Very good. Okay. And what it consists of, Arlen, is we'll get together. We'll spend an afternoon, basically. It depends upon how many entries we had. We probably had a dozen last year. I can't recall. In fact, we had to go out a couple times. Well, then we missed one tree, and then one tree was out in somebody's woods, and it was actually across the river and everything else. But we'll figure that out. So the subcommittee for the big tree contest is Arlen and Wayne. Okay, next agenda item, Home Show 2017, March 24th through the 26th. And Lisa, you've got some commentary on that, signing up and splitting the booth with Park and Rec Department.
Yeah, I checked the dates, and it is March 24th, 25th, 26th. So I think think I may be contacting Molly to see how she set that up, and hoping Shane will help me maybe get the items that we'll need from, I think Molly said at the last meeting, the DNR is able to provide materials. And again, we share that both with Park and Rec, and so it seems like it's not too difficult to get that staffed.
Yeah, that the home show is part of my work plan, so I would be involved in that.
Right.
Yeah. Awesome.
So, excellent. Yeah, we should be, I don't think, and any of you that certainly are,
I'll take a shift or two or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, and I'll get in touch with you.
Okay, excellent.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, very good, thank you. Next agenda item, forester position. There has been no movement on this. Any commentary or anything we need to do there? Okay. Next agenda item, Burr Oak Blight. Any commentary on that? Updates? It's still there? All right.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Center Street Hill and a tree and shrub planting still in planting phase. Nothing to report. Okay. Item K on the agenda, garlic mustard. Joe Gardner has resigned, and Joe, refresh me, what was his position there? He was the one.
Joe's a volunteer,
okay.
You know, very interested in helping to eradicate garlic mustard in our community, just as Alan Van Cura has been doing with buckthorn. And so at this point, we don't have any action planned, or unless you want to formulate a subcommittee or take some action. All I know is that Joe Gartner is not, mm-hmm. you know, being as active in the now or in the future as he has been in the past.
Okay. Well, perhaps we can have that on future agenda, mm-hmm. Future agendas. Gypsy moth trapping. Shane, you got some commentary?
Hey, commissioners, a few months ago, Tom had received an email from John Hanstad from the USDA, and he was reporting that the traps had been picked up and that no moths were captured.
Well, super.
Good news.
That is good news.
Mm-hmm.
Have they ever been detected in this area?
I don't think so.
No.
Not to my knowledge.
So they haven't been previously detected, and we haven't seen anything yet. So good. Very good. Okay. Thank you.
Speaking about trapping, I just want to know, Tom, do you know that, did they also have traps around here for the emerald ash borer? I thought that I read somewhere there was, and I just didn't know of anybody. Or Shane, do you know? I thought there was a report that there was some around.
Yeah, I think the DNR has done some trapping here for that in the past year or two. But I don't have any further information at this moment. You know, we certainly will probably be checking with new commissioner Casey McCoy about that. He'll probably have some information for us.
Okay, moving into new business, we have no items on the agenda. Do we have any new business to discuss?
Mr. Chair, members, this just came up now when you mentioned DNR. Have we done any outreach to the forestry department at the DNR to have them attend the work sessions or come to our meetings in an advisory capacity at all?
Well, all I really know about that is that we encourage the DNR to have at least one commissioner on our commission.
Sure.
And that's usually been the case. As these work sessions move forward, I'm sure we'll design them however you would like them designed, and we can invite experts in on different topics for different work sessions.
I almost see this as something that would fit into their work plan. I mean,
right.
You know,
right.
So
community outreach.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Part of it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So it would just be good to have that resource here to shed light on some of our discussions. You know, never hurts to have that.
Yeah,
kind of.
I would say we'll lean on our new commissioner, DNR Forester Casey McCoy, and I'm sure he'll be quite helpful, mm-hmm. as you know, past DNR experts have.
Okay.
You know, Molly did a great job, and Tom Romain prior to that.
Yep.
Good.
Thank you. Any further new business? Otherwise, our next Tree Commission meeting is scheduled for Thursday, March 2nd, 2017. It mentions 4 p.m. here, so we're going to start the new agenda or the new work sessions at 4 p.m. with the following meeting. Mm-hmm. Let's say we wrap up our work session at 5 o'clock or 4:30 or whatever. Immediately following, we'll have our meeting. Is that the thought?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, we'll have to have a set time for the formal meeting.
Okay.
Yeah, right, that's right. 5 p.m. is what we were going to try to do.
Okay,
is 5
so
p.m.
be locked in. Okay.
Locked in at 5 p.m.
Got it.
Mr. Chair, Commissioners, also about that, I am wondering if we can come up with a different title for the work session to make it more publicly appealing to people to attend. You know, people like to, you know, just getting off work, I'm going to go back to work again, you know. Is there some other, you know, and let's be thinking about that. And maybe just email each other and see if we could come up with an alternative name for it.
Like listening session.
Listening session, or input session,
yeah.
Citizens input session, you know, something like that. So I'm just more friendly, mm-hmm. more you know, appealing for someone from the greater public to show up and come in and raise heck.
I like that. Very good. Any further new business? Hearing none, we are adjourned.